In this video, I will make experiments with the chemistry and with the new paper. So I have an almost exhaust chemistry, around 40 rotations on array 4 chemistry, and I will make a new chemistry and reprint exactly the same picture from Venice, Italy, to compare the results of like new chemistry and completely old chemistry. And also I received new paper, which is also Fujifilm paper without any problems. I can transfer the same settings from the old paper, what I'm using at the moment, to this new paper. The biggest difference is probably the base of this paper, and it's just thicker, so it's much easier to handle by hand, and it's just, you know, feels better. So let's unpack my enlarger and start printing. Several times I was asked how many times I'm actually using chemistry for Array 4 development. And I think this myth about the color and chemistry itself oxidizing extremely fast, and after all you open the bottle, you need to work with it extremely fast, and you need to make single shot developments and things like this. But most of the time this is actually lack of knowledge, and for myself, I debunk this myth even from the beginning when I start to print. All of these principles actually available only if you make the same prints from the same file with exactly the same settings. And you want an extremely high measured by the tool precision and colors. But as you can understand, it's completely not what we're doing here manually in a darkroom. Because I took this negative, you know I will make a corrections for exactly this negative. And as always, even for inkjet printing, you need to make tests. And after tests, you need to apply corrections. And only one thing what I'm caring about is stable starting point. I want to see at least close enough picture from my initial settings and crops and calibration of the color. Because I'm using for my RGB setting, which is exposing the paper, old technology from basically from 70s, and it still works perfectly fine. For sure it will be much better if you have everything more precise and more modern way. But so far, unfortunately, our film industry moving in completely random, strange, unknown directions, complaining about the price of the things, and reinventing the old wheel, which is squeaky and doesn't really work. And in this video I will try to debunk a little bit myth of the old chemistry, and if it doesn't really looks fine, it doesn't really mean it works really bad. So let's start with the calibration, and I'm using my Philips PCA calibrator to find the neutral gray point on my print. Because I'm using Fujifilm paper, it's actually exactly the same emulsion on all variety of paper, and usually in manual you can even read this as the same emulsion and you can compare the settings from one to another. So because I bought the new paper and today I want to unpack two rolls and try to compare the prints, it should be no problem with my calibration. And this first test print, it will be 7 seconds and 70-70-0 settings on my enlarger head. I actually counting only rotations, so basically hand development procedures what I make with my drum, and not the surface of the paper what I actually loaded inside the drum. Because I bought precise paper cutter, in future I will make the special box for test strips, special box for 2 or 3 different types of paper which I will print on. So my first testing procedure is quite simple. So I'm taking one finger length of the paper, cut it in the dark with the scissors, and put this strip on my easel and directly expose the whole strip to take a look if my chemistry works, if my enlargement works, if I have a focus, if I have no dust. And from there I already can judge if I need any corrections and in which direction I need to go. And also I noticed that if you're using water for washing inside the drum, you waste first of all less of water, and secondly your resin on top of the paper more stable, it swell less with the water. So it means it's drying faster, and in principle you cannot scratch it, so it's much better to develop it like this. So let's quickly dry this test strip and check if we need to make corrections. And already you can see the print itself looks a bit cyanish, so the brick wall should be red, but here it's not really clear color. And most importantly, if you miss the color balance, for example the cyan channel, it looks like you're decreasing color depth in one channel and your picture it's not so vibrant and not so colorful as it can be. So my settings here is 8080 and it's measured on f11 and 7 seconds. And from here I will make a step down with the cyan channel. So I will move the yellow and magenta channel down to increase red color, so it means I decreasing the intensity of filtration of cyan. And because I'm using test printer, it's much easier to judge if you have a good color balance or not really. But my personal advice, find the neutral gray position of your picture, for example, ground or the wall or something close to the white or bricks or something like this. Because on the test tripod I have here, even if you dry it, you can only judge if your color balance is correct and right only on a small portion, which is window arrangement. And if it's getting too warm or too blue, you cannot really say it was a light on the picture itself or it was your color cast from the printing. But for now I will choose something like 60-60 settings, make additional test trip and check if I get the right color balance and color correction. So it's much better to overprint with the tests than to ruin the whole paper, and especially the my kind of a dream to have an enlarger which can easily change the magnification. It's extremely easy to make optically, and additionally it will be nice if you can measure with the integration sphere probe inside the photo head after you have a negative installed. So you don't need a search for intensity of the light if you know the distance, and you can easily measure their color balance, and you can always make settings and save them and correct them later. But because today on the market we don't have anything new and kind of a nobody care about this type of technology, you can only make it DIY and create a lot of things by yourself, and maybe somebody will buy it in future. At least here I want to check all of my checkboxes, so for example fix some problems with the old technology, with the light, with the timer, with the things like this, and if somebody need it, make it commercially available. And this print for my taste looks a little bit too much reddish, so it was 60-60 and I want to move to 65-65 and make a final print. And if you compare two prints, you can already see the latest one have a more vibrant color on the bricks, and the print itself looks more alive. And because I'm using 500 milliliter of solution, my problem usually not the quality of the chemistry, but the volume of the chemistry. Because paper itself and the drum have a little bit of retention of solution, you anyway transfer some developer back into drum, and it goes basically to the Blix fix. For Blix fix, it's not a big problem, but for volume after rotations number 40 or 50, you have not enough of volume of solution to cover all the big paper what you can fit in a drum. But this will be a good comparison because my developer already looks horrible and it's dark, and it means my pH of the color developer shifted too much, and probably soon I will see problems with the blue color in the darks. But for now, this print looks pretty much good as I want to see it. I have a small defect here, and probably this is just a water drop. And some people ask me in the comments, did I pre-wash the prints or not really? And if you pre-wash your print, you will not have this type of problems. But now let's make the new chemistry. And I'm using Tetanol kit for 5 liters, but I will make 500 milliliters. It's crazy important and crazy cheap to use the distilled water for all of your solutions. Especially here, because I'm living in Munich, I have a really hard and relatively horrible water for all type of chemistry, and less than 1 euro for 5 liters of deionized water in a standard supermarket solves a lot of problems with your chemistry. And also the same bottle you can use for your waste chemistry. To prepare new solutions, Tetanol kit consists from the two different batches, so it's solution number 1 and solution number 2. So I put distilled water inside the bottle and dose 50 milliliters of solution A and solution B. And I'm trying to put it back and forward to remove the concentrate from my measuring cylinder. I still have a stock solution for 1 liter more, so this is more than 100 rotations in my drum. And the story with the Blix fix is exactly the same, so you have a solution A and solution B, and it's quite straightforward. I also ordered 50 milliliter measuring cylinder, because I'm using 100 milliliter and it's less precise for measuring such a small volume. But as you can understand here, plus minus half milliliter or even milliliter of concentrate is not such a big deal. The chemistry works and everything works fine. And in principle, this Array 4 chemistry is quite modern and it's dummy proof, so you need to be brain dead to not, you know, make the proper chemistry from these solutions. So if you have no experience to working in a chemical lab, remember two rules: more water and easy access to the water around your working area. So you can easily clean up everything if you create a mess. And if you work with these solutions, wear the goggles to protect your eyes. But because I have more than 10 years of experience working in a chemical lab, so preparing of these solutions doesn't create any problems for me. And not changing the settings, let's run the first development on the new chemical kit. It's exactly the same procedure, so I don't make any corrections with the time of development, so it's 45 seconds and 45 seconds, and I make two runs with the pure water and just dry the print after all. And because it's a resin coat paper, you just need to develop the top layer, and for my taste it actually will be much better if the paper itself more plastic and less paper. And as you can see, this print looks exactly the same as print from before. I see a little bit of difference in exposure, but actually in opposite direction. So on the right side I have a less bright wall on the side, but the details and the shadows looks exactly the same. Maybe sky looks a little bit darker or new chemistry, but the difference is not noticeable, and I can say the print on the left is exactly the same print and only one step from there. So even with the old chemistry, this print is really good and I have only one defect, which I basically solve in this print, but I still have a something, but this is probably something in the sky like a cloud. And now let's bring up the new paper. To order the paper, you actually need to pay for two big rolls, and I order the Supreme paper from Fujifilm. It's exactly the same emulsion, but it's a glossy paper. And this type of paper impossible to find in the cutted pieces, so let's try to cut it for the first time. And as you can understand, this box weighs around 15 kilos, and I have a lot of paper for future. So because I have a lot of paper like this, maybe I will put it on my webshop in a pre-cutted form, for example A4 sheets. But before that, even for me, I need to find the proper packaging, because this size of the paper, it's a little bit bigger. And secondly, unpacking this roll was a little bit of disaster. So it's first of all heavy, and secondly, I don't really have a space on my table. And the third thing, I actually don't really have a proper bag for storage. First of all, I end up with a dropping of the piece of paper on the floor, which, as you can understand, it's not really optimal for good results. And this first test print looks a bit horrible, so I tried to make a second one. And here I realized that the box where I store the paper completely not light safe, and only one thing what is actually protecting your paper, it's the two cardboards from the top side and the bottom side, and actually the black plastic. But from my experience at work, this black plastic bags have unfortunately not enough of protection from the light, and if your light is too intense, your sides of the paper will be exposed. And for the beginning, you can use the foil bags with aluminum. And as always, when you make a first moves in an unknown direction, you create a lot of errors, but now I know what to do and I know how to fix it. So this paper, first of all, is much thicker, and as you can see, I have only a piece of black foil. And the left bottom side of this paper piece was on the edge of this black foil bag. But what I like about this paper, it's thicker, it's glossy, and the colors exactly the same. It's maybe a little bit different contrast of the paper, but it's not practically different. So inside the box of Fujifilm paper, you actually have two big rolls without the core. So be careful, and these two rolls is actually separately packaged inside the foil paper wrapping. But for sure you need to open it carefully in the darkness and pack it back exactly the same way. So in future videos I will make more prints with this glossy paper, and I will show my cutting setup. But for the first incredibly horrible and not prepared exposure, it was quite nice and really fun. So I really like I made this investment in the paper on chemistry. And as always, all of my prints you can find on my webshop. Thank you for watching and see you in the next videos.